Hi, I'm Leslie. From the last video, you should already understand what a complete sentence is. You can give different lengths of answers to questions in the conversation, as long as the other person can learn all the necessary information from your expression. It is a good answer. How can you organize all the necessary information well so that Chinese people can understand exactly what you mean? This involves the most fundamental principle of Chinese expression, the word order of sentences. By the order of words in Chinese sentences, you will clearly see Chinese logic, which is the way Chinese people think in communication. The languages in the world are diverse, but there are often more common ways of thinking about the fundamental laws of nature. When you have mastered the logic of how Chinese people put words together, you'll be free to create perfect Chinese expressions without being restricted to the topics listed in your Chinese textbooks. Your Chinese expression will be as direct and clear as the Chinese. As I mentioned in the last video, there are a variety of topics in our daily communication. But in terms of the function of expression, there are only three types of expressions. The first type of expression is to describe or explain a thing clearly. The second type is to give accurate comments. And the third one is to ask targeted questions. I will use several videos to explain what kind of Chinese logic is reflected in the word order of the three expressions. Today, let's talk about the first one. How to organize a sentence to describe or explain something clearly. As in English, the word order for the simplest sentence to describe something in Chinese is subject plus verb plus object. It contains the most basic information, who or what, and do, does. Something is object. For example, 他喜欢猫, 我们喝咖啡, 他们去学校. On the basis of mastering this basic structure, you can add time word, place word, mode word, direction word. So, the sentences get longer and longer. If these messages appear in a sentence at the same time, how do the Chinese arrange their order? Let's look at an example. Describe in Chinese how you go to work. First, clarify the subject, verb, and object. 我上班. Second, add mode words. By subway, by bike, by work, or by car. If you want to say, I go to work by subway in Chinese, the correct Chinese is 我坐地铁上班. Did you notice the word order of the Chinese sentence is completely different from that of the English sentence? In Chinese, you should say, take the subway first, then go to work. But English is the opposite. Say, go to work first, then by subway. These two word orders reflect different logic. Why do Chinese people use this word order? What kind of Chinese way of thinking is behind it? When the Chinese describe an event in one sentence, a crucial logical principle is to describe it in the order in which it happened. Look at this example. You must take the subway before you can get to work. So, when describing how you get to work, the Chinese word order must be 我坐地铁上班 instead of 我上班坐地铁. Because the English translation that matches the second Chinese sentence is, after I get to my working place, I take the subway. It already means something completely different. Therefore, the sequence of actions determines the word order of the sentence. Let's listen to a conversation and see how you should answer in your own words.
你怎么不开车上班? 你是坐地铁吗?
不是, 骑自行车很方便, 我家离公司也不远。 走路也不累。
男的怎么上班？
The question is, how does the man go to work? According to the structure of subject plus verb plus object, the basic Chinese expression is 男的上班。Then you add different mode words depending on what you heard in the conversation. Your Chinese answer can be 男的坐地铁上班，男的骑自行车上班，男的走路上班，男的开车上班。These are all very correct answers. The Chinese vocabulary and the sentence order are correct and express exactly what you want to say. There won't be any misunderstanding. You might say, Leslie, I have said to Chinese people, 我上班坐地铁 or 我上班开车。No one said I was wrong. But I have to tell you, on the one hand, because the colloquial expression is more casual, and this sentence is not long, so Chinese people can understand. On the other hand, Chinese people know that you have tried very hard to speak Chinese, and they respected your efforts, and would not judge your Chinese by the teacher's standards like me.You may also ask, does the word order of a sentence really matter so much? Indeed, because if it is a long sentence, different sentence word order will lead to different understanding. In other words, Chinese people can express completely different meanings by using the same words but different word order. At the same time, if you have no sense of word order, your Chinese reading comprehension will also have problems.So, if you know each Chinese word and put them in the order in which things happened, you could give a perfect long Chinese expression. Your spoken Chinese will improve greatly in no time. Let's take another example. How can this English sentence be accurately translated into Chinese? Let's think about the sequence of actions.The first action is to take the subway. The second action is to go to school. The third act is staying with friends. The fourth action is eating lunch. So the Chinese translation is 我坐地铁去学校和朋友吃午饭。You don't need to use and between each action. This is the Chinese logic of describing a thing in a sentence.Is it simple? There is no complicated theory of Chinese grammar. It's a way of thinking we all have, no matter what your cultural background is. If you can organize the necessary information in each sentence well like this, telling a story or describing a work plan in Chinese doesn't seem so scary, does it? Of course, it takes a lot of practice.Let's start with today's listening practice. Think about your own answers to conversation questions, which you can use the method I have described today.
There are 10 conversations in this video. They will be played together 3 times. During each play, say each conversation only once. In the first play, you will see that each conversation has 3 answer options.Choose your answer according to what you hear. During the second play, you can check if you chose the correct answer. In the third play, there is an English translation of each conversation. Now for the first play.
One.你今天去银行还是明天去？
明天上午、下午都要开会，还是今天去？
男的什么时候去银行？
二，我做了3份牛肉炒面， 两份海鲜炒面，每人一份。
我要海鲜炒面。
有几个人吃饭？
三，这十道题你都做对了吗？
除了最后一题我做错了，别的都对了。
男的做对了几道题？
四，你怎么回家？出租车都停在五号门，机场有地铁二号线。
我和你一起去坐地铁。
女的要做什么？
五，今天十个工程师都来开会吗？
两个人去北京出差了，别的人都会参加。
几个工程师来开会？
六，你的数学作业做完了吗？可以给我看一下吗？
行，差不多都做完了，还有一题，等一下。
男的做完了作业吗？
七，你怎么又迟到了？和昨天一样，又找不到你的手机吗？
不是，我忘了开闹钟。今天起床晚了。
男的昨天为什么迟到？
八，王老师，我们这周都在一号教室上课，下周要换到二号教室吗？
不用，下周还在老地方，老时间。
下周在哪里上课？
九，我要两块巧克力蛋糕。
不好意思，巧克力蛋糕只有一块了，给你一块草莓蛋糕，也很好吃。
你的会有什么蛋糕？
十，你是第一次去成都吗？
两年前我去过，和老板一起去出差，没时间玩。这次我和家人去旅游。
男的第一次为什么去成都？
It is going to do the second play. You can listen to each conversation again.And confirm your answers. Please note that there is no pause between the second and third play. As soon as you have confirmed the tenth answer, the third play will begin. Then you will see an English translation of each conversation. All the right answers will be at the end. You can rate your answers.
一，你今天去银行还是明天去？
明天上午、下午都要开会，还是今天去？
男的什么时候去银行？
二，我做了三份牛肉炒面，两份海鲜炒面。每人一份。
我要海鲜炒面。
有几个人吃饭？
三， 这十道题你都做对了吗？
除了最后一题我做错了，别的都对了。
男的做对了几道题？
四。你怎么回家？出租车都停在五号门，机场有地铁二号线。
我和你一起去坐地铁。
女的要做什么？
五。今天十个工程师都来开会吗？
两个人去北京出差了，别的人都会参加。
几个工程师来开会？
六。你的数学作业做完了吗？可以给我看一下吗？
男的做完了作业吗？
七。你怎么又迟到了？和昨天一样，又找不到你的手机吗？
不是，我忘了开闹钟。今天起床晚了。
男的昨天为什么迟到？
八。王老师，我们这周都在一号教室上课，下周要换到二号教室吗？
不用，下周还在老地方，老时间。
下周在哪里上课？
九。我要两块巧克力蛋糕。
不好意思，巧克力蛋糕只有一块了，给你一块草莓蛋糕，也很好吃。
你的会有什么蛋糕？
十。你是第一次去成都吗？
两年前我去过，和老板一起去出差，没时间玩。这次我和家人去旅游。
男的第一次为什么去成都？
一。你今天去银行还是明天去？
明天上午下午都要开会，还是今天去？
男的什么时候去银行？
你今天去银行还是明天去？
明天上午下午都要开会，还是今天去？
男的什么时候去银行？
二。我做了三份牛肉炒面，两份海鲜炒面，每人一份。
我要海鲜炒面。
有几个人吃饭？
我做了三份牛肉炒面，两份海鲜炒面，每人一份。
我要海鲜炒面。
有几个人吃饭？
三。这十道题你都做对了吗？
除了最后一题我做错了，别的都对了。
男的做对了几道题？
这十道题你都做对了吗？
除了最后一题我做错了，别的都对了。
男的做对了几道题？
四。你怎么回家？出租车都停在五号门。机场有地铁二号线。
我和你一起去坐地铁。
你的要做什么？
你怎么回家？出租车都停在五号门。机场有地铁二号线。
我和你一起去坐地铁。
你的要做什么？
五。今天十个工程师都来开会吗？
两个人去北京出差了，别的人都会参加。
几个工程师来开会？
今天十个工程师都来开会吗？
两个人去北京出差了，别的人都会参加。
几个工程师来开会？
六。你的数学作业做完了吗？可以给我看一下吗？
行，差不多都做完了，还有一题，等一下。
男的做完了作业吗？
你的数学作业做完了吗？可以给我看一下吗？
行，差不多都做完了，还有一题，等一下。
男的做完了作业吗？
七，你怎么又迟到了？和昨天一样，又找不到你的手机吗？
不是。我忘了开闹钟，今天起床晚了。
男的昨天为什么迟到？
你怎么又迟到了？和昨天一样，又找不到你的手机吗？
不是，我忘了开闹钟，今天起床晚了。
男的昨天为什么迟到？
八，王老师，我们这周都在一号教室上课，下周要换到二号教室吗？
不用，下周还在老地方，老时间。
下周在哪里上课？
王老师，我们这周都在一号教室上课，下周要换到二号教室吗？
不用。下周还在老地方，老时间。
下周在哪里上课？
九，我要两块巧克力蛋糕。
不好意思，巧克力蛋糕只有一块了，给你一块草莓蛋糕，也很好吃。
你的会有什么蛋糕？
我要两块巧克力蛋糕。
不好意思，巧克力蛋糕只有一块了，给你一块草莓蛋糕，也很好吃。
你的会有什么蛋糕？
十，你是第一次去成都吗？
两年前我去过，和老板一起去出差，没时间玩。这次我和家人去旅游。
男的第一次为什么去成都？
你是第一次去成都吗？
两年前我去过，和老板一起去出差，没时间玩。这次我和家人去旅游。
男的第一次为什么去成都？
Thank you.